What's up, geeks, and welcome to the channel. Suppose you are given two strings. The first one is just a bunch of characters, but the second one is generated by shuffling the first string randomly and then adding one more letter at a random position. Our job is to find and return the letter that was added to the second string. In this kind of problem, the interviewer wants you to come up with multiple solutions. You see, the amount of code required to solve such problems is small compared to other questions we may encounter. And the aim here is to be able to produce more than one solution and be able to compare these solutions to one another. So, the first solution that I personally came up with after reading this problem is sorting. You see, if we manage to sort these strings internally as an array of characters, they will basically be equal except for the slot where the extra character was added. And if after sorting these strings we traverse them simultaneously, we will be able to easily figure out that character. To implement this first solution, all you must do is transform both strings into arrays of characters, sort the character arrays we just generated, revert them back to strings, and then proceed by traversing both strings simultaneously until a different character between the two is found. If we manage to find that character, we return it. If we don't, meaning we reach the end of the first string without finding the added character, then the character must be the last one standing in the second string. That's it. Now, another solution is to make use of maps. Of course, when the words distinct or same or occurrence pop up, sets and maps are usually the way to go, and this problem is no different. The solution takes in the longest string, which is the second one, and places all its characters inside a map. The key will be the character itself, and the value will be the occurrences of that character. After doing that, we take the other string, or the first one, and start removing the occurrences of its characters from the map we previously populated. After we finish looping over both strings, the map should contain a single character having a value of 1, and if any, all other characters should have a value of 0. So we retrieve that character and return it. Now, to compare these two solutions, the second one should theoretically be faster as we are linearly looping over both characters of the string, whereas in the first solution we are sorting, and sorting has a time complexity of n log n. But practically, they'll both be similar in terms of overall performance as neither of them is optimal. Okay, after coming up with both or one of these solutions, the interviewer might ask you to try to come up with another solution that keeps the overall logic linear in time, but does not require any additional space to store the character or the occurrences. How do we do that? Well, to come up with the solution, you will have to remember basic bit operations, and in particular, the XOR operation represented by the caret symbol. Why? Take any three numbers and apply the XOR operation on them. If two of these numbers are equal, then the result will 100% be the third number. And because characters are basically numbers in their code representation, then if we apply the XOR operation on all the characters making both strings, the result will be the extra character added, which is the solution we are looking for. To implement this solution, all you must do is initialize a character as 0. This character will be used to accumulate the result of the XOR operations. Then go ahead and loop over both string characters one at a time by cumulatively applying the XOR operation on them. After traversing both string characters, we can simply return the result. That's it, the optimal solution to the problem at hand. The link to the LeetCode problem we solved today can be found in the description below. Let me know your thoughts and suggestions for upcoming videos in the comments section. And that's it for today. I hope it was helpful. Thank you guys for watching. Take care, and I will see you in the next one.